Hello, and welcome to the Divine Light Healing Meditation for March the 6th, 2024. The picture behind us is by Jean-Luc Pozzoli, and we're just going to do a general healing meditation. We have a few people on our list, and settle in and enjoy. So you can gently close your eyes if you like. Breathe in deeply. And then as you breathe in and breathe out slowly, start to visualize the light coming in the top of your head. So we generally see, let's first of all have the white, silver, sparkling light coming in from above, coming in through the top of our head. There's a nice swirl around to rinse all of our thoughts and our minds clean from the day. Rinse round in our jawline. Do a nice swirl around through your throat and your neck, just letting this white, silver sparkling light spiral through our body. And it comes down gently to spiral through your top of your chest and your shoulders. No rush. Spiraling down through your lungs and your rib cage, spiraling through your digestive system, swooping through your belly, through your hips, and through your reproductive system. You can spiral, or if you feel figure eights coming through your body, if the light washes that way, that's also fine. Let that light continue down through your legs, through your knees, right down through your feet and drain into the earth. So we've got this white, silver, sparkling light coming from the sky, through our bodies like lightning rods and into the earth. And just watch yourself as if from the outside to see that white, shining, healing, bright light coursing through your own body. And your body connects the earth and the sky. Breathe into that and visualize that. And now with that same gushing river of light that's coming through you, allow color to drop into that. So maybe you see a bright yellow right now, or pink. You can watch it change just like a disco ball or a rainbow. The way that light does shimmer if you're looking into a pond. Just watch the colors shimmer through your own body with the light that's coming through powerfully from your head. And so feel the washing motion of that light through your body as it's just rotating in a spiral motion, or any motion that you do feel is fine. But that light is moving and cleansing through your body. Now, on the people that we're healing in our list, we have some with infections and some with some diseases, such as COVID, colds, and flus, very common at this time of year. And so all of those infections and diseases can be healed with the light. So all of us here in the circle, imagine holding your arms out, or actually hold your arms out if you would like to. And bring that light that's been coursing through our bodies and washing through our bodies, allow that orb of light from yourself to grow larger. So let it pulse larger out to the size of your own arms. And so just it's swirling like a vortex or like a whirlpool. And now let that pulse even larger to the size of, say, the room that you're in or the house that you're in, so that you're now connecting with all the other people in our circle. Remember, it's not just the people that are here right now. It's also our guardians, our guiding ones, our helpers. As you're feeling the swirling of the light and the people in our presence, take a look to your left and see who might be to your left. It might be a guiding one, a friend, a spirit guide, a spirit animal. And who's to your right in this circle? Can you see any others in the circle? Just enjoy this time. Enjoy the light. Enjoy the beauty of the other beings that are here with us meditating. It's lovely to just be in this floating, healing light together. And now imagine all the people who need healing. Let them be in the center of us. And now allow that big light that we've all connected in this sort of torus or ring of energy, let that get even brighter, and infill all the people in the center of our circle. So this might be quite a very large circle that we're in right now, spanning miles and miles, or just within a room. Doesn't really matter. Time and space are somewhat imaginary. Just feel that light and let it go straight into the center, like the spokes of a wheel. We're all shining bright light. If you know Care Bears, it's like Care Bears care. We're all shining our light, shining our healing into those people in the center that can use a little help. And so this light that was swirling through us is now swirling through all the people in the center of the light. It's shining very, very bright. And so as it shines bright in them, it's like igniting little flames. So as it touches the infection, and as it touches any particles of disease, as it touches emotional troubles that are stuck in their bodies, you can just see little flames lighting. So as we shine through to the center of the circle and it touches their disease, it makes these little flames, just like little Bunsen burners, everywhere that they need. It's not a burner that burns them, it's like little sparkles that purifies those diseasements. So as that purifies their diseasements, just watch it get brighter and brighter. And now you might see ashes come falling down to the bottom of where they are in the center there, just perfectly fine. It's just the release of those infections. Remember, as our body heals infection, it often just needs to release that matter that it's finished with. And so watch that diseasement and those infectionish bits just fall to the ground. And just refresh that light again. And it can be lovely after some fire like that to start to feel some rain. So let's feel the universal rain come down on top of our whole circle so that we can all feel it. You can feel a cleansing rain. So it's refreshing and cool. And maybe sometimes it feels a bit like sparkle light. And just watch it come not just down through our bodies. We can feel it come down through the top of our head, the top of our shoulders, down through our torso, through our legs, through our feet, and down to the ground. Watch the same thing happen to the people in the center of our circle. The rain comes down, sprinkles down in the top of their heads, straight through their bodies like they're sponges, sparkles and sparkles of healing rain. Refreshing them, cleansing them, washing away anything they would not like. Just let it sprinkle down through their knees, down through their feet, and into Mother Earth. And all of that diseasement or ash nurtures Mother Earth. It fertilizes new growth to come. Let's do it again. Just visualize a beautiful, pouring, gentle rain coming down through the whole circle, down through the whole circle. healing everyone within it and everyone that's holding the healing space on the outside. Just washing, cleansing, refreshing. And now just stand at the edge of the circle and observe how you yourself feel and anything else that you may see of the people in the circle and the people around the edges of the circle. Breathe in deeply and receive any messages that you may receive from others in the circle. And now we're going to take flight a little bit ourselves. So you can either hold hands with the beings on either side of you if you wish to, or you can go by yourself and just allow yourself to feel light. The same way that we just felt water coming through our bodies, now start to feel air and clouds under your feet. So you just start to feel that those clouds are lifting you up, that your whole body is just rising with total delight. You feel just light as a bubble, as light as air, and you can just rise up effortlessly as high as you would like to go, either onto a cloud or a magic carpet. You can either look up or you could look down below you. It's your choice. Just get there and get yourself comfortable. When you get to wherever you're going to stay for a little while, you might feel yourself to sit cross-legged or to lie down on your back or on your belly, whichever way feels happiest right now. Just get there on your cloud. Feel the amazing comfort that you're feeling where you are. What is underneath you is supremely perfect. It's exactly what you want to lie upon. And your body feels grateful. Take in a deep, deep breath. And it's so wonderful to just be able to breathe so deeply. It's so wonderful to be able to move our arms and our legs. It's so wonderful to be able to think these clear thoughts and to feel clear emotions. And so now, on your private place that you're sitting now, allow yourself to experience three separate emotions. So right now, choose your first emotion, any one. And I want you to breathe in deeply. Experience that emotion, either a so-called good emotion or a so-called bad emotion. There are no good or bad emotions. You know, anger can be a help if that's what you need right now. Joy, of course, always feels good. But just choose one. It doesn't matter. Don't put a judgment on it. Choose an emotion. Breathe in deeply. Feel that emotion. Picture yourself having that emotion. Think about an object or person or animal that makes you feel that emotion, and experience that just by yourself now for a few seconds. Okay, now, whatever feeling that put in your body, release it, good or bad. Feel the air or the clouds around you, where you are, just swirl through the mists, just swirl straight through your body and erase whatever emotion that you just had. Feel some sun or some rainbow or some rain on your face. And now let in a second emotion. Feel it fully. Picture whatever in front of you is making you feel that emotion. And let that emotion come into your body. Again, let those mists start to come through, swirl through your whole body, and realize as you're there, you're still sitting, you're still a person, but your emotions are not you. Your emotions are like the weather. They can come and they can go. Our emotions are only as real as we allow them to be, and we can feel them deep in our body. We can let them sit. We can choose to clear them out. So now choose a third emotion, or let the emotion choose you. Breathe in deeply. Visualize whatever in front of you makes you feel that emotion. Breathe deeply for several breaths and just experience that emotion. And let it go. And now think back on the three emotions that you had and what colors they have. And then think about the interaction of those three emotions in the day-to-day life. How can you use each emotion for action or for health? Or maybe some emotions don't feel like they were healthful. That's okay too. Acknowledging that it's there is a step to clearing it out. If it was something that you think you don't want to spend a lot of time with, that's an effective piece of information right there. Breathe in deeply and let it all go. And maybe just have some rain from above again, and let's just wash that whole experience away. So just rain pouring through you, or sun pouring through you if you prefer sun, bright beaming sunbeams or buckets of rain, and just watch it wash through your whole entire body until you feel translucent and bright, like you are a crystal. In fact, let's imagine that. So, wherever you're sitting, or go somewhere else if you prefer, become a crystal. Either you are the crystal or you're in a crystal, whichever feels more appropriate to you. I like to visualize that I am the crystal. Take a look at the color of that crystal. And just feel yourself as clear, bright, and focused. So not only are you clear and translucent, you might have inclusions like a piece of quartz that there's little clouds here and there. And those little inclusions, which are maybe our own little personality traits that people bump against, those inclusions in a quartz can sometimes stimulate the imagination and stimulate thoughts. So even those little things that we might find to be flaws in ourselves can actually be what brings the greatest illumination. Sometimes a perfectly clear bit of glass is not as beautiful as one that's a little smoky. So just look at yourself as a crystal. What shape are you? What colors are you experiencing as a crystal? What are your little smoky inclusion-y bits? What feels most true and most good? And now imagine at the very bottom of your crystal, resting against whatever you're sitting on, that there's a little fire. So there's a little fire in the crystal, and the fire just comes right up like a magic fire and fills the entire crystal with warmth and just burns in a healing way. So it's not burning in a scary way, it's just burning with flames. Because we know that flame hardens and purifies. So if we were a bit of iron, rusty bog iron, with impurities in it, and we were put into the flame, and we were hammered, and we were stretched, and we were hammered, and we were burned, we would come out as the strongest, brightest, sharpest steel. And so it can be as it this flame burns in our crystal. There might be events in our lives that are trying, but they don't necessarily weaken us. They can strengthen us. They certainly, those experiences help to burn away and let fall down what doesn't matter anymore. And now let that fire just fade away, die down to ashes, cooling to just as cool as you'd like to be, or stay warm if you prefer. Now I would like you to get in a vehicle or on a horse if you want, or a dragon, ride however you would like to ride. We're going on a little journey. Now I want you to visualize either a road or a road in the sky, either way, but choose a path. So we're going on a road trip for several thousand kilometers or miles. So as you go on this road trip, put down all your baggage here. You don't need any baggage for this trip. So if you would like to, you can have somebody in your vehicle or beside you on another horse or dragon, or maybe the horse or dragon is your accompaniment. That's okay. So put this person or being beside you or with you, however you like, and just start to go down the path. Have a conversation with this, your friend or guide, whoever's with you, and notice what you see along the way as you travel. Notice the bumps and the obstacles and the beautiful things of your scenery, and pay attention to your discussion. I will be quiet for a minute while we all experience that. Breathe in and breathe out. Push the accelerator and go. Now, maybe in your conversation, you discuss where your destination is. Where would each of you like to end this trip? Maybe it's not the same place. Come to your destination either with or without your travel partner and enjoy your destination. Do whatever you would like to do in your destination. Experience how wonderful it is to be there. What does it feel like under your hands and under your feet? What does it feel like against your skin? How does the air feel in your destination? What brings you joy about that destination? Why did you choose that destination? And now, who else will join you at your destination? Have a little party where you are, if appropriate. I hope it's an appropriate place for a party. Or stay by yourself if you prefer. See who else is with you and how you feel, and see if any of those people have any messages for you. A little party with them. know somebody comes and gives you a beverage to drink. Drink deeply of this beverage and see where that beverage decides to take you and what change it makes for you. Okay, so we'll wind up the party. Just swirl your hand and the party disappears. Because just like the emotions we experienced before, all of the people and even the guiding ones in our life may suddenly disappear. And we are still here. We are still ourselves. We are still the only ones we are born with. And die with. We may have other spirit family with us or near us. They're never guaranteed to be there at any particular second. There's always somebody with us. So from that cloud that was the party, rise even higher. So just allow yourself to shoot up into the 15th dimension. Just straight to the 15th dimension, up, up, up into the sky. Breathe in deeply. See the colors that you see in the 15th dimension. Feel yourself within a large spherical temple, if that makes sense. This temple or this place has Akashic records in it, has all the knowledge of the universe in it, and it's all accessible to you. So travel to a place within this sphere. And see what message there is for you to find. And now look out the windows of the temple and see what you see outside. Enjoy the beauty of that vision. And move within the temple to another location. You might greet other people in the temple moving around as if it's a giant library. Or maybe you're there and you feel that you're by yourself with all that wisdom. You choose. It's your journey. Now experience your body in a physical sense, perhaps not as a human, or as a human if you prefer, but experience how your body feels in that place. How do you move? Just move your body. Experience it. What is the wisdom that you know from the way that your body moves? What is the lesson from this for how you can interact in your daily life back on Earth? What is the importance of the lesson of the way you move up here? And how is this experience of moving your body compared to how your body moved in lives before? What do you love about moving like this? And what would you not love about moving like this, if anything? If there's something you don't love, change it so that you can move exactly as you would like to. Perhaps you want to burst out of this body and fly, or swim, roll, move through the earth. Feel the actual tactile sensations of moving with the body that you're not used to. What information do you gather as you move about the world around you, or information from the records around you? Now, somewhere in this large spherical temple in the 15th dimension, see a crystal ball. It may or may not be occupied by orbs of light, of spirit. Move towards that ball. And now find some orbs of spirit and talk to them and see what they have to tell you. Watch the way that they move. What do these orbs have to tell you about your own health? What do these orbs have to tell you about your emotional state? What do these orbs have to tell you about your week ahead? Or your other time ahead. And now turn so that you look back into the sphere where you were before, and just look at how many orbs are filling that entire sphere. So many more now that you started to talk to a few. You can see that we're surrounded by so many beings. So many beings at this party with us. So much wisdom, so much knowledge, So many experiences that have been had in the human lives on Earth and in other lives. And with each life that's lived, wisdom, knowledge, and experience collectively grows. As Abraham Hicks says, there's no thought once thunk that can be unthunk. And all of these lives lived have added to our collective consciousness. Worlds that have passed and become extinct. Worlds that are yet to be. And we will be part of that wisdom, that accumulation of orbs. Time is not linear. Prosperity is not linear. Everything is cyclical, and we have access to it all. Just enjoy the sheer joy of being with all these amazing beings who have no agenda. They're just happy to be here with us. It feels like fizzy rainbow sparkles in our bodies, whichever body we're in right now, in our hearts, lifting up our lungs with every breath that we breathe. We feel the energy of the universe supporting us, nurturing us, giving us those magical elements we need to survive. It's almost too much to take in. Take in as much as you can of those rainbow disco sparkles. And then slowly let yourself descend again. Back to Earth. Gently falling down, but in a contented, peaceful way. Bring those rainbow sparkles and that memory of joy with you. That memory of being any kind of body you want to be. That memory that this is not the beginning, this is not the end. We had a certain number of people in our first journey, or beings. And when we go up and we look higher, there's more available. We don't have to feel limited by the people we may or may not be in contact with on Earth at this moment. We can reach for more. And as we reach for more on a higher plane, we can attract more here now. So feel yourself on Earth and feel strings, all those rainbow nanites or orbs. They're all putting strings out of you to other places on Earth now, to other people. Thousands and thousands of connections of positive, abundant, beautiful, loving connections in every direction. Smile. And as you go through the next week, every time you smile at a stranger, they might be someone that was touched by one of these connections now. There are more connections than we understand in our human form. And those connections can bring us wonderful, wonderful things. And when we need to, if we want to, we have the right to cut connections we do not want. and to create boundaries for ourselves. But we also have the right to forge new connections, new, brighter, more beautiful connections. Breathe in. Feel deep love and sunny, bright, totally positive connection with yourself, the universe, with the wonderful beings around you. Just rest in that bright, bright, sunny, yellow, silver sparkling, golden sparkling, pink, purple, blue sparkling, green, any color. Feels great to you. You're just a giant sparkling, glittery disco ball. Put your glittery and shiny all the way through like a crystal. Just breathe in and be aware of yourself that way. And after this meditation, when we open our eyes, you're still this sparkling crystal. You're still this person that can shine this incredible light outwards. Every time you smile to a stranger, you will be sending that light. You'll be sharing that light and that healing. And that's the true gift. Namaste, peace. I hope that you have a wonderful week ahead. And I hope that you smile at many people. If you don't see people because you're at home for some reason, then send little emails of smiles. Send little nuggets of joy, little nanites of joy, and little compliments, at least one per day. Thank you, and have a wonderful week. See you next time.